Hi children, welcome back to our computer class. How are you all? I hope all are good. We completed our first chapter, isn't it? Today we are going to the second chapter, that is advanced features of MS Word. You know what is MS Word? It is an application software. It is used to perform special tasks on the computer. It is a word processing program, isn't it? Today we are going to learn about MS Word. It is designed to help us create professional quality documents. With the finest document formatting tools, Word helps us organize and write the documents more efficiently. That you already learned in the previous classes. It contains efficient formatting tools. Then it also includes powerful editing and revising tools. So we can create our document more efficiently. Okay, then how can we open an MS Word window? First click on start button, all programs, then Microsoft Office, select MS Word or Microsoft Office Word. Okay, yes, MS Word window will appear. Which are the elements of MS Word window? First one, title bar. This is title bar, top of the window. Quick access toolbar. Next, ribbon. Working area. Status bar. What is a ribbon? Ribbon contain tabs and groups. Ribbon contain different types of tabs and its groups. That you already learned. Yes. Then, here we have home tab, insert tab, page layout tab, reference tab, mailing, review and a view tab. Each tab has its own different groups. Okay, yes, let's start. First is page orientation. What is page orientation? We can choose our page either portrait or landscape. Don't forget that names, portrait or landscape. Portrait means tall and narrow. Landscape means wide or horizontal. Okay, portrait means tall and narrow. Landscape is wide or horizontal. Okay, then how we choose this orientation? For that, first click on page layout tab. First click on page layout tab. In that, page setup group. Okay, the page layout tab contains a page setup group. Okay, in that page setup group, one option is here, that is page orientation. Orientation. Can you see that? Orientation. Okay, then click on orientation. Two options are there, that is portrait or landscape. Which one you want? Then you select. Okay, first I am going to choose portrait. It's already in portrait orientation. So then I am going to choose landscape. Look at the difference. Look at this. The page is wide. It's horizontal. Okay, then again I am going to choose portrait. Look at this. That page is narrow or tall. Kanda a difference manasilagunnundo ningalku? Orientation randomunda, then portrait or a landscape. Portrait means tall and narrow. Landscape means wide. Okay. Yes. I am going to choose landscape. Look at this difference. And yes. That is orientation. Landscape or portrait. Got it? Yes. Now we are going to the next point, that is different page orientations on same document. In the same document, we can choose a different orientation. How can? For that, click on. First, you have to something right here. Okay. We don't have time to type. That's why. Paste. Okay. how can we choose different page orientations on same document? For that, select the page or paragraphs that we want to change to portrait or landscape orientation. Here I am going to choose only two lines, that is a part of a document. Okay, so not whole document, it's a part of a document, only two lines I selected. Okay, yes, then click on page layout tab, then page setup group. Here one margin option is here, can you see that margin? Yes, click on custom margin at the bottom of the drop down menu. നോക്ക് മാർജിൻ ക്ലിക്ക് ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ ഇവിടെ ഒരു ഡ്രോപ്പ് ഡൗൺ, ഈ ലിസ്റ്റിന്റെ നെയിമാണ് ഡ്രോപ്പ് ഡൗൺ ലിസ്റ്റ്. ഇതിന്റെ ഏറ്റവും താഴെ ബോട്ടം ഓഫ് ദാറ്റ് ലിസ്റ്റ് കസ്റ്റം മാർജിൻ, ലുക്ക് അറ്റ് ദാറ്റ് കസ്റ്റം മാർജിൻ. ക്ലിക്ക് ഓൺ കസ്റ്റം മാർജിൻ. എ ഡയലോഗ് ബോക്സ് വിൽ അപ്പിയർ, എ ഡയലോഗ് ബോക്സ് വിൽ അപ്പിയർ. ദിസ് വിൻഡോ ഈസ് കോൾഡ് എ ഡയലോഗ് ബോക്സ്. ഓക്കെ, on the margin tab, it contain margin paper layout. In that margin tab, click portrait or landscape. I am going to choose portrait. Okay, which one you want, you can select that. I am going to choose here portrait. Then click on apply to. Here one option is here, that is apply to. Two options are there, whole document or selected text. I am going to choose selected text because I am already selected here. Okay, so selected text, then click on OK button. Look at this, I choose only two line, that is a part of, that was a part of the document, isn't it? That is in one page, the next one is in another page. Okay, got it? Yes. That means you can choose the different page orientations on same document. കണ്ടോ? Yes. ഇവിടെ നാല് ഈ ഡോക്യുമെന്റിൽ ഞാൻ ടൈപ്പ് ചെയ്തത് ഒരുമിച്ച് ഒരു പേജിലായിരുന്നു. അപ്പൊ ഞാൻ എന്ത് ചെയ്തു, കുറച്ച് ആ പോർഷനിൽ അതിനകത്ത് കുറച്ച് പാർട്ട് മാത്രം ഞാൻ ചൂസ് ചെയ്തു, എന്നിട്ട് കസ്റ്റം മാർജിൻ കൊടുത്തു. ദാറ്റ് മീൻ എന്തിനാ കസ്റ്റം മാർജിൻ കൊടുക്കുന്നത്? കസ്റ്റം മാർജിൻ എന്തിനാ കൊടുത്തത്? ഒരു ഡോക്യുമെന്റിലെ കുറച്ച് പോർഷന് മാത്രം വേറൊരു ഓറിയന്റേഷൻ എനിക്ക് ആവശ്യമായിട്ട് വന്നു, അതുകൊണ്ട് ഞാൻ ആ പോർഷൻ മാത്രം സെലക്ട് ചെയ്തു, ഓറിയന്റേഷൻ കൊടുക്കാൻ വേണ്ടിയിട്ടാണ് കസ്റ്റം മാർജിൻസ് യൂസ് ചെയ്തത്. അപ്പോൾ പേജ് ലേഔട്ട് ടാബിൽ, പേജ് സെറ്റപ്പ് ഗ്രൂപ്പിൽ മാർജിൻസ് എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ബട്ടണിൽ ക്ലിക്ക് ചെയ്യുമ്പോൾ ഒരു ഡ്രോപ്പ് ഡൗൺ ലിസ്റ്റ് വന്നു. അറ്റ് ദ ബോട്ടം ഓഫ് ദാറ്റ് ഡ്രോപ്പ് ഡൗൺ ലിസ്റ്റ് വൺ കസ്റ്റം മാർജിൻ ഇസ് ഹിയർ. ദെൻ ഇൻ ദ മാർജിൻ ടാബ് വൺ ടു ഓപ്ഷൻസ് ആർ ഹിയർ, ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് പോർട്രേറ്റ് ആൻഡ് ലാൻഡ്സ്കേപ്പ്. You can choose anyone from here. Then click on apply to. Selected text or whole document, whatever it is. What do you want? Then you can choose that. Then click on OK button. That's all. Okay. Next is page margins. Page margins. Page margins are the blank space around the edge of the page. That you know. In general, we insert text and graphics in the printable area inside the margins. Okay, what is margins? It's a blank space around the edge of the page. We can choose a margin from margin gallery or by creating custom margins. Otherwise, setting predefined page margins. How can we apply this margins? First one, from margin gallery or by creating custom margin, otherwise setting predefined page margins. Got it? Yes. How can we set the page margin? For that, click on page layout tab, the page setup group, click margins. A margin gallery drop down list will come. You can choose any margins from here. Okay, so I am going to choose this one. Okay, I chose one margin. Okay, first step, on the page layout tab, page setup group, click margins. A drop down list will come, that is margin gallery. You can choose any margin from here. Then click that. That's all. Okay. Then creating custom margins. How can we create custom margin? That means you can give the left margin space, right margin space, then bottom margin space, etc. Like that. For that, click on page layout tab, page setup group, click margins. A drop down list will come. At the bottom of that, a custom margin is here. Click on custom margins. A dialog box will appear. In that top, look at this margin contain top, bottom, left or right. You can give any values here. 2, 4. Okay, that's all. You can give top value, bottom value, left and then right. Okay, then click on, after that click on OK button. Look at this difference. What is the step? Click on page layout group, then page layout tab, page setup group, click on margin. A drop down list will come. The bottom of that list, a custom margin is there. Click there. Then what happened? A dialog box will appear. Then choose the value of, that means you can give the value of top margin, bottom margin, left margin and the right margin. After that click on OK button. That's all. Okay, today it's enough. Please read the textbook nicely and watch the video. Otherwise you don't get anything. Okay, yes. So let's wind up, children. Thank you and have a nice day. Bye bye.